Good evening everyone, welcome to Arpita Sharma classes. I am Arpita Sharma, your educator, and today we are going to analyze 5th June 2020 the Hindu newspaper. Aap sabhi ka swagat hai Arpita Sharma classes mein. 4th June 2020 the analysis of the Hindu newspaper will be uploaded very soon. Bahut jaldi 4th June ka bhi analysis upload ho jayega. So today we are going to analyze 5th June 2020 the Hindu newspaper, the DNA. Also, there is an important announcement regarding UPSC prelims new dates, revised dates, which we are going to analyze that too as well. And the class PDF will be uploaded on my Telegram channel. Telegram channel pe class ka PDF upload ho jayega. So you can access the PDFs of the classes on the Telegram channel. Class ke jitne bhi PDF hote hain, announcement, notifications hoti hain, sabhi hamare Telegram channel Simplifying UPSC with Ease par announce ho jati hain. So you can access them there. Ab wahan par unko access kar sakte ho. All right. Now starting with the announcement. So as you can see over here, this is the revised program of examination recruitment test by UPSC. Over here, Civil Service Preliminary Examination 2020 is going to be conducted on 4th October 2020. 4th October 2020 ko exam conduct hoga hamara, right? And the mains exam will be conducted. Either over here you can see the mains exam will be conducted on 8th January 2021. यहाँ आप देख सकते हो हमारा मेंस का एग्जाम और प्रीलिम्स के एग्जाम की डेट्स आ गई हैं. सिविल सर्विस मेंस एग्जाम 2020 8th जन 2021 एंड प्रीलिम्स एग्जाम विल बी कंडक्टेड ऑन 4th October. सो इफ वी आर गोइंग टू गिव आर मेंस आर प्रीलिम्स इन अक्टूबर, जब हम अपना प्रीलिम्स जो है अक्टूबर में दे रहे हैं, राइट, दैट मीन्स यू हैव गुड अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम. नाउ जून यू हैव, देन जुलाई यू हैव, August and September, right? तो आपके पास अच्छा खासा time है. Now, even if you have not seriously prepared prelims, then also you have time to crack prelims. अगर आपने seriously भी अभी तक prelims की तैयारी नहीं की है तो आपके पास 4 महीने का time है, बहुत अच्छा खासा time है. Even in 3 months you can crack prelims. Now you have 4 months, right? So you can here start giving mock tests, revise. कंप्लीट योर करंट अफेयर्स ब्लैक बैकलॉग्स, जितने भी करंट अफेयर्स के बैकलॉग्स हैं वो कंप्लीट कर लो. मॉक टेस्ट देने हैं, रिवीजन जितनी कर सकते हो उतनी ज्यादा से ज्यादा करनी है, राइट. एंड ऑल्सो स्टार्ट राइटिंग वन मेन्स क्वेश्चन, मेन्स बेस्ड क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करना शुरू कर दो. डाउनलोड प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर एंड स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग देम. ओके, क्लियर. So you have good amount of time now. And those of you who are preparing for 2021, आप में से वो बच्चे जो 2021 की तैयारी कर रहे हो, राइट, एग्जाम डेट्स आर नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज. ओके, आप यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर एज इफ योर एग्जाम इज इन जून 2021. ओके, क्लियर. आप ये मत सोचना आपका एग्जाम आगे पीछे हो जाएगा, नो, राइट. प्रिपेयर एज इफ यू हैव योर एग्जाम ऑन 1st June 2021 और 31st May 2021. प्रिपेयर इन दैट मैनर. ऑल राइट. Now also another important announcement. Tomorrow I'm going to take a special free live class on Unacademy Plus. 10:30 AM in the morning. It will be a 60-minute lecture. The topic of the class is Get Your Doubt Solved UPSC CSE. अगर आपका कोई भी डाउट है UPSC CSE से रिलेटेड, आपके सभी डाउट्स कल की क्लास में लिए जाएंगे. मॉर्निंग सेशन, 1 आवर सेशन, 1 घंटे का सेशन होगा 10:30 से 11:30. And on Unacademy Plus, the link is given below in the description box. You can register yourself in the class. It's a free class to be conducted by me live on Unacademy Plus. So all your doubts regarding UPSC preparation will be solved there. आपके जो भी doubts हैं UPSC CSE से related, आपके सभी doubts को मैं लूँगी और solve करूँगी, ठीक है? And before starting the analysis, subscribe to this YouTube channel for daily Hindu news analysis, important international organization lectures, prelims preparation के लिए daily MCQs we are conducting, polity classes, economic classes, etc. And if you want to subscribe to Unacademy Plus, you can use code Sharma20 to get 10% discount. 10% discount लेने के लिए Unacademy Plus पे ये है कोड जिसको आप यूज कर सकते हो. Now the first important topic, World Environment Day. Now 5th of June every year is celebrated as World Environment Day. It started in 1974. The event has grown to become a global platform for public outreach that is widely celebrated in over 100 countries. This year's theme, that is 2020's theme, is biodiversity. Is saal ki theme hai aapki biodiversity. Remember the theme. In view of the prevalent situation due to COVID-19 pandemic, ministry will be holding virtual celebrations on World Environment Day. द थीम विद विच इट विल फोकस ऑन नगर वन. नगर वन मीन्स द अर्बन फॉरेस्ट. तो दिस ईयर थीम इज बायोडाइवर्सिटी एंड इट इज गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन नगर वन. नगर मीन्स अर्बन, फॉरेस्ट वन मीन्स फॉरेस्ट. ओके, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस फॉर प्रीलिम्स. नाउ ओवर हियर यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द कंट्री इज एंडाउड विद रिच बायोडाइवर्सिटी एंड थ्रू वर्ल्ड एनवायरमेंट डे वी आर स्प्रेडिंग द अवेयरनेस टू कंजर्व द एनवायरमेंट. The नगर वन इज द फोकस एरिया. इस साल के वर्ल्ड एनवायरमेंट डे का फोकस एरिया है नगर वन, दैट इज द अर्बन फॉरेस्ट. अर्बन फॉरेस्ट विल हेल्प इन क्रिएटिंग एंड एनहांसिंग द लंग कैपेसिटीज ऑफ द सिटीज. वी ऑल नो दैट इन द अर्बन सिटीज द रेस्पिरेटरी प्रॉब्लम्स आर इंक्रीजिंग. सो बाय स्प्रेडिंग अवेयरनेस अबाउट नगर वन वी आर गोइंग टू एनहांस द लंग कैपेसिटीज ऑफ द अर्बन सिटीज. द वज्र अर्बन फॉरेस्ट इज नाउ अ रोल मॉडल फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ द कंट्री. The food we eat, the air we breathe, the water we drink, and the climate that makes our planet habitable all comes from the nature. So if we protect the nature, we will protect our livelihood, right? For example, each year marine plants produce more than half of our atmosphere's oxygen. Very important point for prelims. And a mature tree cleans our air, absorbing 22 kilos of carbon dioxide. So we need to protect them when they are doing so much for us. Right, without speaking a word, without uttering anything, without asking anything in return, then we should also conserve them. We should also do something for them, right? Despite all the benefits that our nature gives us, we still mistreat it. So that is why we celebrate World Environment Day to spread awareness about nature. World Environment Day is hosted by Colombia this 2020. Last year it was hosted by China. This year it is being hosted by Colombia. Clear? First important news for today related to GS Paper 2, India and its neighborhood relations. India-China dialogue to focus on three areas. The first ever talks between Indian and Chinese lieutenant generals over the weekend to ease the tension on line of actual control will focus on eastern Ladakh, with the aim of moving back to earlier positions. That means whatever right now problems, disputes are going on the line of actual control, talks will be conducted now. Now the focus of the talks, this is very important point for prelims. The focus of the talks will be on Galwan area, Pangong So and Gogra. Now what is Galwan area? This is important for prelims. Galwan river flows from disputed Aksai Chin region to Ladakh of India. It originates, underline this, it originates in the area of Samjung Link on the eastern side of Karakoram Range and flows west to join the Shyok River. It is one of the upstream tributaries of the Indus River. And what are the countries which are covered in this by this river? China and India. Now let us understand about the Pangong So Lake. Pangong So Lake in eastern Ladakh has often been in news, most famously during the Doklam standoff also, which happened in 2016. When a video of scuffle between Indian and Chinese soldiers was released. So in Ladakhi language, Pangong means extensive concavity. And so is a lake in Tibetan language. Pangong So is a long, narrow, deep, endoheric. Endoheric means covered by land. Landlocked lake. Situated at a height of more than 14,000 feet in Ladakh Himalayas. It is a brackish water lake. It is not a fresh water lake. It's a brackish water lake. Clear? It freezes over in winter and becomes ideal for ice skating and polo games. The legendary 19th century Dogra General Zorawar Singh is said to have trained his soldiers and horses on the frozen Pangong Lake before invading Tibet. Very important point for prelims. Now this editorial is very important. Ye editorial kafi important hai for GS Paper 2. A chill in US-China relations. Now, this editorial talks about the deterioration of US-China relationship after this pandemic COVID-19. COVID-19 ke baad, ek tarike se US aur China ka relationship kaafi niche aa gaya hai. The USA under the Trump administration has issued a couple of statements and action plans, which is a clear indication that competition between US and China is likely to sharpen in the post-COVID world. That is, after COVID, this competition is going to strengthen up between US and China. Trump administration said it would revoke matlab cancel. It would cancel Hong Kong's special trade status under US law. Administration also passed an order limiting, that is restricting the entry of certain Chinese graduate students also. So in the education sector also, US is not leaving China. Isme bhi restrictions डाली जा रही हैं। The US President has also ordered financial regulators to closely examine Chinese firms listed in US stock markets and warned those that do not comply with US laws could be delisted. US government has decided to bar passenger planes from China from June 16. Trade war, which President Donald Trump launched in 2018, is yet to be resolved fully. It is also going on right now. Trump and other officials in administration have been attacking China over its handling of COVID-19 pandemic. Now, is it same as the US-Soviet Union war, the Cold War which happened? क्या ये उसी की तरह है? Right now, what is happening between US and China, is it same as the Cold War? There are similarities between current crisis and Cold War. The political elites of both China and US, like Soviet Union and US back then, they see each other as their main rivals. Same thing is repeating. History repeats itself वाली बात हो रही है, right? Today, history is repeating itself. Right, we are being reminded of the Cold War era. But there are key differences as well. There are third parties like EU, Russia, India and Japan. These parties increasingly have a choice whether or not to align with either power as they see fit and on a case-by-case basis. This leads to very different kind of international order than the Cold War. During the time of Cold War, there were alignments made. But during this time, European Union, Russia, India and Japan, they are free to make their choice. They can support either party or they will not support either of them. Unke paas choice, they have choice to support or not to support, right? Ties between China and US are still not as bad as they were between Soviet Union and US. Right now, there is a silent fighting going on. But at that time, the relationship was really screwed up between Soviet Union and USA. Right now, it is not the case. Clear? And plus, military confrontation is also very low. Right? Bahut hi zyada low hai military confrontation US aur China ke beech. So how the US-China relationship evolved? President Jimmy Carter terminated diplomatic relation with Taiwan in 1978 to normalize the relation with China. China ke saath relation normalize karne ke liye Taiwan ke saath apna relation tod liya tha 1978 mein US president ne. President George W. Bush washed away the sins of Tiananmen in 1989 for momentary geopolitical gain as well. Bill Clinton, who as a presidential candidate had criticized Bush for indulging the Chinese, he also tried to, proceeded as a president to usher the country into World Trade Organization. All right. So all American administrators since 1960s have been complicit in China's rise in the unrealized hope that it will become a responsible stakeholder under Pax Americana. But every Chinese leader from Chairman Mao to President Xi Jinping have been clear-eyed that US represents existential threat to continued supremacy of communist regime. Now over here, China's indirect confrontation with US, the indirect confrontation, not the direct one, the indirect confrontation. Let us have a look at it. So China is trying to build an alternate trading system through the Belt and Road Initiative because it knows that US is trying to, will pose as a threat in the trading era, right? In the trading arena, US will pose as a threat to China, right? US accepts its own supremacy, right? If China is trying to dominate, US will have problems. So China is building an alternative trading system, that is the BRI. Multilateral banking system under its control, that is the Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank and New Development Bank. It is also building its own global positioning system, the GPS, which is known as Weidou. And the digital payment platforms like WeChat Pay and Alipay. It's also building a world-class digital network. Now, China is trying to indirectly confront USA. China is trying to show USA that we are not dependent on you or we are not on your mercy, right? It is going under the nose of Americans and some of it with the financial and technological resource of the West. Now, how US has responded to this? Ab US kaise respond kar raha hai is par? US is already at war with China. But a few have also cautioned, they have also warned that this should not escalate into Cold War as USA is still entangled to China's supply chains, right? We are also entangled, US is right now entangled with China's supply chain. So if we are going to announce a full-fledged Cold War, it will cost USA a lot. Bahut zyada dikkat ho jayegi USA ko. Clear? Now, in this context, we should understand China's wolf warrior diplomacy. It is a new approach inside China. एंड री एनफोर्सेज प्रिज्यूम ट्रांजिशन ऑफ चाइनीज डिप्लोमेसी फ्रॉम कंजर्वेटिव पैसिव एंड लो की टू असर्टिव प्रोएक्टिव एंड हाई प्रोफाइल. वुल्फ वॉरियर एंड वुल्फ वॉरियर टू, दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. वुल्फ वॉरियर एंड वुल्फ वॉरियर टू आर चाइनीज एक्शन ब्लॉकबस्टर्स दैट हाईलाइट एजेंट्स ऑफ चाइनीज स्पेशल ऑपरेशन फोर्सेज. दिस डिप्लोमेसी इज नेम्ड आफ्टर दीज मूवीज ओनली. ये जो मूवीज क्रिएट की थी चाइना ने, इसी के नाम पर डिप्लोमेसी भी तैयार की है. इट डिस्क्राइब्स ऑफेंसिव्स बाय चाइनीज डिप्लोमेट्स टू डिफेंड चाइनाज नेशनल इंटरेस्ट इन कन्फ्रंटेशनल वेज. मेनी चाइनीज बिलीव द वेस्टर्न मीडिया पोर्ट्रेयल ऑफ चाइना इज हाईली बायस्ड. वुल्फ वॉरियर डिप्लोमेसी इज अ पार्ट ऑफ चाइनीज गवर्नमेंट्स एंडेवर टू टेल द चाइना स्टोरी, राइट? सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस फॉर मेन्स. नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूज, वॉट रिलीफ इज अल्टीमेटली ग्रांटेड इफ इंटरेस्ट accrues. So right now the Supreme Court in a virtual court hearing reacting to RBI regulatory package wondered what relief had ultimately been granted if loan interest continued to accrue for the moratorium period. Now RBI said we are going to give moratorium period, that for this period the banks will not force the people to pay back their loans. But the interest will keep on accruing. Interest लगता जाएगा. भले ही आप loan मत pay करो 3-4 महीने के लिए, interest पड़ता जाएगा. Then Supreme Court is asking, what is the relief you are providing? You are asking on the other one hand to the people that you can not, you are relieved from paying loan, from paying back your loan for a certain time period. But your interest will accrue. On the other side, the interest will accrue. It will become outstanding. So what is the relief that you are providing to them? Supreme Court reacted to RBI regulatory package. The three-judge bench said that there were two issues in this case. One, whether interest should be charged at all during the moratorium period. If you are really trying to help people out, right, then should interest be charged? And second, whether there should be an accrual of interest to be paid by the borrower in bulk or at monthly basis after lifting of the embargo. Now, if you are lifting up the moratorium, then the in bulk, in, you know, in one go, you are going to take, ask for the money. Or on a monthly basis. The hearing came a day after RBI filed an affidavit in court saying that it did not consider it prudent or appropriate to go for a forced waiver of interest, risking the financial viability of the banks. So what is the relief? Why to announce this? Right? Agar aapko banks ka dhyan rakhna hai, toh relief bhi kyun announce kiya? Okay? Now next important news, India-Australia meet strengthens ties. India-Australia held a bilateral virtual summit. This summit was conducted. It is the first time that Indian Prime Minister held a bilateral virtual summit. The virtual summit signifies strengthening of ties with Australia and its upward trajectory. So India and Australia raised their relationship to comprehensive strategic partnership after this virtual summit. We have concluded 9 agreements with Australia and one of them is a mutual logistics support agreement. Now, this mutual logistics support agreement will allow both militaries, the reciprocal use of base, humanitarian and disaster relief cooperation, port exercise, passage exercise. For example, if Australia is facing some certain humanitarian crisis or disaster crisis, then India will help them. If India is facing such crisis, Australia will help us. They issued a joint declaration on a shared vision for maritime cooperation in the Indo-Pacific region as well. So in the Indo-Pacific region also, Australia will help us. Australia will be supporting us. The two countries have agreed to increase the frequency of meetings between two prime ministers. They also took the 2+2 format of bilateral meetings. That is, 2+2 means the foreign and defense minister of Australia will meet the foreign and defense minister of India. Both will collaborate and cooperate with each other. Right? Next important news, Tablighi activity now a specific visa violation. The Union Home Ministry has included indulging in Tablighi activities as a specific visa violation that will attract a fine of $500. Home Ministry has added a new category, restriction on engaging in Tablighi activities in general policy guidelines relating to Indian visa. Guidelines provide details of 24 categories of visas and various conditions under which they could be granted online or by missions abroad. So, as per the amended guidelines, foreign nationals granted any type of visa and overseas citizen of India card holders shall not be permitted to engage themselves in public work. First guideline. Second guideline, there will be no restriction in visiting religious places and attending normal religious activities. Only the tabligh activities are restricted. Third important guideline, preaching religious ideologies, making speech in religious place, everything will not be allowed. $500 fine is also for other violations like overstay of more than 2 years, visiting protected areas, and cases involving both overstay and visa violations. These are important for your mains. The MHA had blacklisted 960 foreigners who participated in Tablighi Jamaat event, because of which there was a spike in the COVID-19 cases. So far, total of 2,600 Tablighi foreigners have been blacklisted from entering India for 10 years under Category A of the Visa Manual 2018. Now, what is Tablighi Jamaat? It's a society of preachers. It focuses on purifying the Muslim faith. Founded by Deobandi Islamic scholar at Mewat in 1926, it has a presence in 150 countries. Now, this particular paragraph is important for your prelims. Very, very important, especially the year. Disasters displace lakhs, says study. State of India's Environment 2020 report has been out. It is the annual statement on the state of affairs in environment and development sectors. The report is published by, very important for prelims, Center for Science and Environment. CSE also publishes Environment magazine Down to Earth. जिस magazine को आप पढ़ते हो ना geography optional के लिए, वो magazine भी Center for Science and Environment publish करती है. The report covers forest, wildlife, agriculture, rural development, water and sanitation, and climate change related aspect. So this report says India had 1 in 5 of all internal displacements caused by disasters across the world in 2019. Mostly it was caused by floods, cyclones and drought. There were more than 50 lakh internal displacements in the year. Now these points in the report you have to remember for prelims. Ye aapko prelims ke liye yaad rakhna hai. Right? Clear? The forest cover has shrunk in 38% of the districts. 5 out of 21 river basins are now in a state of absolute water scarcity. This is the finding of the report. And what has caused this displacement? Flooding has, which was caused by southwest monsoon. It led to 26 lakh displacements. Then cyclone, Fani, it led to 18 lakh displacements. Cyclones, Vayu, Bulbul, these are the reasons. Natural disasters, drought conditions, forced migrations, these are the reasons which were highlighted in the report. Next important news, Center launches internship scheme for 25,000 graduates, important for prelims and mains, GS paper 2. The center has launched a scheme to provide internship opportunities. The scheme is TULIP, very important for prelims for 2020 and 21. TULIP means the Urban Learning Internship Program. This portal was launched. It's a welcome move at a time of soaring unemployment. However, there is no guarantee that these interns will get paid any stipend. Guarantee nahi hai ki stipend milega ya nahi. But skill development will be done. Right? Scheme is a 5-year joint venture between Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs and All India Council for Technical Education. City administrations can register available opportunities on the portal. The program does not have any budget of its own, but 100 smart cities and 4,400 urban local bodies can use the administrative expense allocated by center to pay stipends or perks. Next important news, bring PM CARES Fund under RTI. Says plea. Public interest litigation, there is a separate chapter in M. Lakshmikant book on PIL. Do study that chapter today. Okay. It has been moved before Delhi High Court seeking greater transparency in the PM CARES Fund by bringing it under the coverage of RTI. If the money is being used properly or not, how much percentage of the money has been used till now. To know all this information, the PIL says that PM CARES Fund should be brought under the ambit of right to information. Right now, the petition cited recent newspaper reports of PM CARES Fund refusing to divulge information sought under the RTI Act by claiming that the fund is not a public authority. That means it is not under RTI Act and it should be brought under the RTI Act. Next important update regarding Vande Bharat Mission. We have studied about Vande Bharat Mission a lot of times in our previous analysis also. It's a rescue mission. Ye ek tarike ka COVID-19 ka rescue mission hai. So a total of 3,48,565 citizens have been registered till now with the Indian diplomatic missions. Registered Indians have been brought back by a mix of non-scheduled commercial flights, ships and cross-border bus services from Nepal, Bangladesh and Bhutan. Remember the countries, the name of the countries. Clear? So this was all for today. I hope you enjoyed today's class. If you really enjoyed it, do not forget to Like the video, share the video with other aspirants and subscribe to the channel. Also, do not forget to register yourself in this live special class which I am going to conduct tomorrow in the morning at 10:30 a.m. The class is Get Your Doubt Solved related to UPSC CSE. Link is given below in the description box. On this note, we are wrapping up the session. Thank you, everyone.